Hello folks, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. So today's video, we are diving into the email application Spike. Spike's in its second edition. They released a new update. The new update mainly focuses around the tasks and notes you can add. Not too much changes around the sort of basicness of the tool in terms of its basic functionality. But in today's video, we're gonna be diving into how it works, the pricing, all of the details that you need to know, and hopefully find out whether it's a suitable email application for you. So without further ado, folks, let's dive into today's video. So as you can imagine, there's a lot of conversation about email applications at the moment. We actually checked out Hey from the folks at Basecamp at the start of this week. The kind of Peter Eckes, who is another fellow YouTube creator, who sent me an invite. So I will be doing a tour of Hey.com. And we also are doing a lot more on Superhuman as well. So there's this conversation about email at the moment. A lot of people looking at sort of paid email and things like that. The difference between Spike to some of those is that is what's called conversational email. So it blends the aspects of a group chat with your email. So as you can see here, it sort of looks like I've got like Facebook Messenger open because of the way that it's structured. And it doesn't feel like an email, which is one, nicer if you're chatting with people on a regular basis. And two, it is easier to communicate in terms of like you sending a regular message to someone. It just feels a bit nicer. So as you can imagine, we're going to dive into the how it works and all the overview. I'll touch on the notes and tasks abilities about midway through, because I want to convey the basic concepts to you. But let's touch on the pricing first, because that's sometimes the most important thing. It rules out whether you're going to use it or not. Now, the pricing is actually a little bit better than some other applications. They have a free plan. And that does include all of their applications, all of their apps available on desktop, mobile, and web. I'm using the web version on this video today. But they do, in that free plan, up to 100K messages searchable, which does limit you. But at the same time, it's probably about 6 months of search. So again, if you have something past that, then that history is going to not be available unless you pay the free plan, the paid plan. you have to pay the paid plan. And then they have some limitations when it comes to the group chat and notes and tasks. So you can see there's 5 gig storage, 5 megabyte upload limits. But they do have in the free plan the automated rules that includes like the snoozing, the pinning, the blocking, which you'll see in Gmail as well. But they do have encrypted emails, voice messages, video messages, and basic support. So the free plan is, I'd say, fairly reasonable, and apparently they do include ads inside, so that's even better as well, something that Gmail does to help support the platform. They do have a pro plan, which naturally gives you unlimited of all of this sort of jazz, like unlimited file upload, unlimited notes, unlimited searchable access, and that's $5.99 per active account per month. So I believe, say you had like it on monthly, that was the annual plan, at $7.99 a month. And I believe that's like per active account. So if you connected with, say, like you can connect with Gmail, Outlook, Yahoo, Hotmail, iCloud, Office, Outlook 365, Honest Mail, GoDaddy, Exchange, AOL, and all IMAP type, which is fairly good actually, something that a lot of people like to include in their app. So as I said, Spike is a conversational email. So when you're sending messages to each other, this is my conversation with the founder. I actually had a video call with him last week, mainly just to overview the and get my questions answered about Spike and their second version, and naturally give a bit of an overview. And you can see here that it looks like I'm messaging as Facebook Messenger, and you can actually reply to things and open up messages, have longer string messages. So we'll get into the email composing in a bit, but you can see here that all of your messages will appear on this side. You then have a way to connect up your calendar. You can connect up Outlook calendar, Google calendar, and much more. So you can see my Google calendar has just been imported in, so that's fairly good. This plus button allows you to add events and actually begin connecting them to your Google Suite. In this case, I'm G Suite connection. And over here, you can create a group per, for example, study group, family, personal, vacation, etc. And once you start those conversations, you can have real-time communication with them. So you can actually start a spike chat, which essentially, if the others get spike as well, will become a real-time conversation. So you don't just have your emails, you'll have your calendar and your group chats potentially in one place. And you can even see a list of people that have spike, anyone with the green dots next to them, and all of their email addresses and access there. So now I've got the sort of basics out the way, the new feature that is being touted inside of Spike 2.0 is something called Spike Notes and Tasks. And essentially they're collaborative notes that can include to-do lists, you can embed files, you can embed documents inside there, but you can also connect up and share it with other people, which makes it much more like a Google Doc and much more suitable for teams collaborating on it. So they have an example here. You can embed video, you can embed GIFs, you can even embed files and start to-do lists. And as you can see here down at the bottom, it will operate in the same way like a Notion document in some extent. For example, you can create some of the basic formatting and some of the tables and code, etc. Now up here, you can add people, you can share that, you can copy link, you can even see a revision history as well. And also, you can start conversations on this right-hand panel. I think Devir just sent me a document that we can collaborate on together as an example. And you can see here, this is a document. And if I'm sort of like typing away, he would be able to jump in and edit this in real time together. So there is some benefit to it. I think a lot of people would like to see, obviously, the notes and the tasks in the same location. And also, like, starting those notes can be a lot easier. So say if you're, you know, powdering through your email or inbox, you can get to inbox zero and then constantly keep notes and tasks for the day. If you're someone who spends a lot of time inside of that sort of platform, then this can be useful. Now, one of the things that was one of my concerns when I started out was in regards to what this looks like on the other person's end, because obviously you're seeing it like a conversation. How does the other person see it? I actually looked at what it looks like inside of Gmail, and to be fair, it actually looks pretty smooth. You get, whenever you create an account, the ability to have this signature they create for you, which is quite cool, which is a profile photo, and then you're sending it via chat at Spike. But you can turn that off if you go over to the settings area. So there is ability to play around with this and make it a little bit more fine-tuned. A lot of people ask about the dark theme. They do have a dark theme too. But as you can imagine, it's quite handy and helpful. So let's get into some of the nitty-gritty stuff. So the thing that I'll mention before is apparently their security side of stuff. They say we are ad-free, never touch, access, manipulate, reuse data, and all is fully encrypted. In addition, got full audit approval by privacy and security via an external company suggested by Gmail. So that tends to be quite good when you're looking at security side of things. Now, the other thing they do have is this sort of filtering system. So you'll see emails coming in separately and this box called priority. So you have something called priority and other. So other basically filters out stuff that is actually outside of, you know, the regular emails you're sending, and naturally will filter it down in its own area as to not interrupt the stuff that you interact with most. So this is the real-time collaboration I was mentioned, and you see Devir is mentioning this Forbes article here, but you can see here that this is him in real time. So that's quite cool in the fact that you can collaborate with others, but this is again reliant on them having Spike, which sometimes you know, can be a little bit of a hard sell if you're trying to get somebody else on an email platform. So let me show you a few of the other items up here. You can open up that person's thread and you can see any threads that you've started and even start what's called a Spike call or Spike video chat, essentially video meeting and voice meetings, which is quite cool. And up here with these three dots, you can change it to unread. Things you traditionally do in an email, you know, move it to tomorrow, today, star it, and even mute it. And you can even move it to the other area, which means that it will go into this at least priority area. In this case, I may want to move this back. But then the system learns because, for example, if you're using something like SaneBox, which I use, it actually replicates some of these abilities in helping to clean out unnecessary emails, make the inbox a little bit smarter. So down here, as I said, you can start a sort of subject line. So if I was to say, compose a title, you can write the message down here. And if you want to, you can open it up into its own window with all of the sort of regular sort of composing stuff that you'd have down at the bottom. Now you can add a range of things. You can add a spike call and just get started on the call straight away, or you can even browse your files or send recent files that you've uploaded to Spike. Now if you click this smiley face, you can actually add GIFs and they'll embed in line, which is quite a nice addition, especially if you're chatting to someone quite regularly that is a bit more relaxed and happy to accept them. Now inside of all of the emails that you send, although it doesn't feel like an email, you can do a range of things. For example, reply to it, trash it, star it, forward it, even snooze it for later. So you can move that one for later and that will naturally remind you later. And you can do that per thread. So if you wanted to archive the entire chat, the chat should come back with that specific item highlighted. Coming back to this point, this is how the conversation works on this right hand side. And you can naturally do a range of things with each of the documents create. So you can edit the tags, you can actually star it or save it for later. So if you, for example, wanted to start listing out some of the tasks you've got for tomorrow, let's go ahead and do that in saving a new note. So let's call this one tomorrow's tasks, if I could learn how to spell. I can then start, say, listing out some items. So I could say edit YouTube, plan week ahead, and clear inbox to zero. So maybe there are a few tasks for me to do tomorrow, and then I could go up here and actually to save it for tomorrow, which means that that will pop up in my inbox at the right time tomorrow. So you can go to a specific view of certain, say, notes or tasks. And if you want to go ahead and create your own task, you can do a quick task. So for example, if I said like, edit YouTube, save task, and naturally it should fall into this area. There we go. So you can actually change the status of it by going to done here. And that's perfect because you'll get a notification or a little tick to say you've completed that item. Now, if you go back, it actually still appears in the main thread. But if I wanted to, I could go to settings and I could see all of the modifications. So I can actually organize conversations by inbox, or I could organize them through subject, maybe the title of the subject or all recent activity, and then by people as well. You can change the modifications to the snoozing, like how does later by today plus 3 hours, is that something that you can modify? Like is your later today 5 hours time? You can modify the scheduling of the send. So for example, if you wanted to change what that looks like, and you can even set the zoom, for example, if you wanted it to be zoomed in a little bit. And you can also change some of your calendar settings too, at like connecting the specific calendars that you have. Now you can go in and modify some of the tags, the signatures and the aliases that you have created. And you can modify the way that your picture and profile appears. So if you're wondering what like newsletters look like, this is how a newsletter will appear. You can open the messages up and naturally newsletters will appear as a regular email, but a lot more sort of refined, I'd say. I guess if you're looking for a specific one, you can find it there. So what's cool is if you select an item and you say wanted to delete it, it would trash all 90 messages that are inside of it. So if you're deleting one of the items, you can move all of them as well, all previous email features. So there is some filtering abilities. So for example, you can filter which ones have been unread, and you can even mark them all as read. You can actually go to search and specifically find priority based stuff, starred files, and also attachments and things like that. So a few of my final opinions on this application, looking at the conversational email side of stuff, it's something that I actually sort of rejected to start out with. I remember seeing the product maybe a year and a half ago and going, you know what, it doesn't feel right because I feel like email is a much more formal process. But whereas when playing with it, it feels more natural and it seems to work in the other end, like it seems to do the job in being able to send quick messages. So I do like the conversational email aspect of it. I think that's actually changed my mind. And I think if you're somebody that spends a lot of time on email is much more relaxed in your communication with people. So say you use it for personal, or use it for, you know, personal branding, or I don't know, but in a way that you feel comfortable with your email recipients and sending stuff to them, then I think this is quite a nice application for you. Especially because of the prioritization of certain emails, and also filtering out all those newsletters. I think that's a really nice sort of ability, and also the ability to connect to your calendar as well. And that's something a lot of email apps don't necessarily always have inside of them, the calendar abilities, so that's always nice to have. Now, when it comes to the newer features, the note-taking and the tasks, I think this is really, for many people, probably an optional experience, something that is a nice add-on, but won't necessarily blow you away. If you're someone that takes regular notes to yourself in email, maybe sends them to yourself, or you want to combine your email with your regular note-taking on a regular basis, you spend a lot of time in email and you don't necessarily want to move out, then this might be for you. So some of the collaborative abilities, if you were able to convert your teammates or friends over to this application, it does make it easier to be able to send those messages and communicate in real time. So what I'm saying here is I like the conversational email. I think that's pretty cool. I think it makes it a lot more of a relaxing experience for email. But what I'd say is the more tasks and notes are a nice to have versus a necessity for some people. So it's really up to you how you view that. But at the same time, I think they're built well. It's just not necessarily a core component. I know what they're trying to do, bring everything in one place, but at the same time, I think it's a nice to have. So folks, I hope you enjoyed my feature of Spike 2.0. Again, this is growing applications. And from what Devere was saying, I can imagine it is going to be very popular as time goes on and how people view it. So I hope you enjoyed this feature. I'll include all of the relevant links and details in the comments below, but I hope you enjoyed today's video. So if you're new to this YouTube channel, please do subscribe. We do regular features like this and would love to have you here in the community. But if you wanted to share your thoughts on Spike, whether you've used it or not, please do use the comments below. All right, folks, I will see you all very soon. Cheerio.